hands upon this ministry. Thank you for your good hands upon my life. Regard the sound. Thank you again for his hands, Jesus. Father, I regard your good hands, O God. Thank you for his good hands. Thank you for his good hands upon your life. Father, we thank you for your good hands upon us, O God. We regard your hand, O God, in operation, O God. We regard your hand, O God, Maroko, because several times the Lord has plucked out his hand to help us. Father, thank you for your good hands, O God, upon us as a church, individuals, upon our partners also. We return the glory. We return the praise. Father, we thank you. 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 Maliki sule brakalabaya. Jigive kosukira kalabandia. Ragaba sule kalabana salosa. Maliki sule brakalabande. Mandike sukulabaya. Jigive kosule kulabande. Limbroko brekule kalabande rai. Segibo kola fez vehiculo sarala sirubai. Thank you, Lord, for your goodness and mercy. Thank you for your good hands, O God. Father, we give you the glory and praise. We magnify you, Lord, for your good hands. Thank you and thank you and thank you and thank you, Lord. Thank you for your good hands, God. Thank you for your good hands, God. Thank you, Holy Ghost. 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 Thank you, God, for your hands and life, God. Bless the name of God. Hallelujah, Lord. Amen. Hallelujah. Lord, I give you the glory and praise today. Hallelujah. For your good hands upon our lives and upon our families, upon our works and business and upon our jobs, your good hands upon us mightily. Thank you for the testimonies, O God, from inception. Thank you for your eternal God. The Lord said this word to you today. Hallelujah. We are resting part of five God's on your life today in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. His city is Mount Zion. That's the place of the gathering of the saints. This gathering is first here on earth, and it's also happening in heaven. Hallelujah. In Hebrews chapter number 12, we see that this place of his glory is a place of power, is a place of salvation, is a place of deliverance. But he had come unto Mount Zion, unto the city of the living God, the heaven Jerusalem, and to an innumerable company of angels, to the general assembly and the church of the firstborn, which are written in heaven, and to God, judge of all, and to the spirit of just men made perfect, to Jesus, the mediator of new covenant, to the blood of sprinkling that speaketh better things than blood of Abel. Hallelujah. See that he is, if he's not he that speaks. Hallelujah. So we have a blood that speaks in Zion. Hallelujah. And it speaks with the voice of the owner, Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Hallelujah. Every man's blood carries voice. We know that. Hallelujah. This ministry. And of course, we know that the Christ's blood given to us through the fruit of the vine, if we bless it, he says we will sprinkle a charism of his voice, because he says it shall become shed blood, matched to the seas. To the seas. He said the blood we bless is called, this is my shed blood. Hallelujah. So which means we'll sprinkle it, the same effect we have in blood. Hallelujah. So in Mount Zion, the blood is always speaking. What? Speaking down the hand of God. In Egypt, when their days were due, God told Abraham they'll be there 400 years. But now it's 430 years. Nothing was happening more than 400 years. And they were praying and doing all kinds of things. Nothing happened. And one day they say, I'll bring one more plague that will speak for your deliverance. When he speaks, I always hear. And he said that was the first time he has to let understand that without mercy, my hand can operate. Hallelujah. It says in Isaiah 59 verse 1 and 2, my hand is not sure I cannot perform, but your sins have made me to slow down. So every nation is going through tumult because the iniquity of our nations are high. So the hand of God can really operate in nations. That's why it seems, I mean, wickedness takes over the nations, because there's iniquity so strong. Even those who do so wickedly, they also work iniquity so that they perpetuate what? The thing to be seen. When they do say, what happened? God's hand is withdrawn. So they have room to do it very, very well. So if there is sin, God's hand can perform. So in Zion, power is there because the voice in the blood of the Lamb. Hallelujah. What would the blood do? The blood came to Jesus. He said, take a lamb for a family. They took that and they slew. And the blood sprinkled on the earth. When they put on a sample, the blood sprinkled on samples on the earth. And the blood began to speak to God, crying, mercy, 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 mercy. And you know in Psalm 102, verse 8, the Bible says, thou will have mercy, what? On Zion. What? They said, and what? So without mercy, God's hand can't come to bring favor. Hallelujah. So we are come to Zion where the blood speaks for us to perpetuate the hand of God upon the life. Hallelujah. He said, to the blood that speaketh. There are so many things mentioned there. The God, they don't talk always. God don't speak always. Angels don't speak always. But he placed a blood that speaks to speak mercy always for God's hand to work. My hand is not too short that I cannot save. But the sins of the nations have made me to withdraw. That's why the devil took over nations now and all kinds of things happened. Hallelujah. That will be our case in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. So we are in Zion where the blood speaks. That's also where what the hand of God manifests. As I say, upon Zion, the blood shall be deliverance, what? Holiness. And what? You possess what? Your possession. Hallelujah. So until there's holiness, you cannot take what is yours in Zion. Hallelujah. So Zion gave us the blood to perpetuate righteousness, cleanness. The blood will remove iniquity so that the hand of God can manifest for power deliverance. So it says, upon Zion, what shall be brought? Holiness. What happened? Deliverance will come. So the blood will bring holiness. That will bring what? The hand of God for deliverance. The blood brings holiness. It will purge Zion and its content, which will make the hand of God to manifest to bring what? Salvation for them. Hallelujah. Receive the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. It's a day of the hand of God. One of the things that hinders the hand of God is what? Filthiness or sin. So we have to make sure that we engage the blood regularly as a means to perpetuate his hand upon us. My hand from the short I cannot say, but your sins has kept it away from you. May that iniquity, every sin, my Father, my God, every sin that hinders God's hand upon my life, they are purged by the blood. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. Now it's a month of prayer, answer prayer, and what? Fullness of joy. And one of the things that make that happen is what? The hand of God. In fact, it's like the month of the hand of God. You know why? Answer prayer is by the hand of God. If you pray, it is God's hand that carries out the answers. Hallelujah. When God, what happened? Things will happen. You can pray, but he said God also walking with them, making their prayer, their words, to come to pass with signs and wonders. So it is the hand of God that actually works those things to testimony what you are praying. That's why if you pray in iniquity, there is no answer, because the hand of God is what is hindered from actually coming from his bosom. You see that Psalm 24. He said, why hide your hands? The reproach is too much. You know why? When the hand of God is hiding, all Christians are reproached. They are reproached. Because the hand of God's word is the power for the deliverance. So if the hand is kept in the bosom, Psalm 24, why hidest thy hand in the bosom? Pluck it out for us, O God, so that we can see what? We can breathe again. So we can have what? Freedom again. As long as God's hand is kept in his bosom because he's angry with you for sin or upset with the church for anything, there cannot be miracles in that church or in your life. So God's hand needs to come on board for you to change. In Psalm 24 verse number 10, he said, oh God, how long shall the adversary reproach? So they will continue to reproach our lives, fight us with lack of poverty, fight all kinds of things, as long as God's hand is not in action. So he said, how long shall the adversary reproach? Shall the enemy blaspheme thy name forever? Why, Lord, withdraw thy hand back, O God, for us? No, please help us, God. Even thy right hand, pluck it out of thy bosom and do something for us. So as long as God's hand is not out of the bosom, you cannot see tangible testimonies. It is the hand of God that brings what? Testimony. To build up your business and your life. So he said in Psalm 28 verse 5, because they don't regard my hand for them, what? I will stop what? Building them up. Psalm 20 verse 5, because they regard not these things, they don't give me thanks from my hand, they think it's normal thing, it's one of those things, I'm very smart. No, it is the hand of God that does it. I'll tell my brother one day, I say, look, if you do get this kind of breakthrough, it's because it is the hand of God, not because anybody's wise, he knows how to handle. No. Some breakthrough cannot come except by the hand of God. Some things can happen because there's a hand on the wicked also, except by the hand of God. Why? There's also what? The hand of the wicked. There's also what? The arm of what? The wicked. That's what I reproach you. That works charms, prepare charms, the hand of the wicked to pull you down. There's the hand of the wicked. That's why we need the hand of God. There is the hand of the wicked. That's Psalm 37. So that's why we need the hand of God. There's a hand of the wicked over people's life. Psalm 37 and verse number 12. The wicked plotted against the just. If you're ready for me, from verse 12. Psalm 37 from verse 12.
The wicked plotted against the just, okay, and gnashed upon him with his teeth. The Lord shall laugh at him.
You see that?
He seeth that his day is coming.
So that thing is doing it. What is the day God will bring out his arm? What happened? The guy is finished. So he said, don't worry. If you can make my hand come out, don't worry, I'm coming. But your own, I'm more happy with you. I'll do some things. If you look at Revelation chapter number 3, 1, 2 and 3, he said to them, he will first praise them, Abi. He said to the church of this, I know your good works. You are this, you are that, but I have this against you. Stop this one. I don't like this one you're doing. Then you go to the church of Sardis. He say, I know your works. You are the one that don't allow Satan to do anything. You are working very hard for me, but I have this against you. This particular area, I don't like what you're doing there. Then you go to that. So all the churches had one thing he had against them. So that area, God's hand can manifest in their life. You get the point? So he said, repent, lest I come, no problem. So you can be very good minister, but there's nothing you do. There's, it can be quite any area of, as a pastor, there can be area you must look at very well. Because in this area, please, if I come, make sure it's what? That's the area that is common in your family. You know, we talked about testament from the Garden of Eden. When they give them that apple, he put in them rebellion. Now, when it comes to every man that's born again, the sinners doesn't bother, because the Bible says the sinners are already condemned. You see, in the book of Peter, you see, if scratches are hardly saved, how will be sinners? They are condemned now. But for a Christian, he leaves the sinners where they finished. But to a Christian that's trying to form that I'm a Christian, he comes to you to check the weakness in your family lineage. There's something in the blood in your family that they come to, they bring you, pull down. When it comes there, you pull down, you can't help you except God helps you. Like you saw, we talked about Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. We saw that they lied by their wife, three of them. It was in their lineage. So there's something he puts in us, he put in Adam, if that's gone through our life, but they express differently in different families as it comes. You get the point? So when Bible said, and the prince of this world came to Christ and found nothing, because he had no link with Adam's blood, because Joseph was cut off from the pregnancy, from the pregnancy. God made Mary pregnant. So based on that, now he was free. That's what he comes to look for in our life. That's our weakness, from where he brings us down. As a man of God, God says, I know you are doing very well, this, but there's an, this one, make sure, watch it very well. Somebody came and told grandfather-in-law the wife was speaking to him. He said, be very careful, this woman that is doing this thing. He said, no, the woman is a zealous person. He said, no, honey, this woman, you know. And when the woman manifested, when he got home, he was looking at her wife like this. He said, no. So when a woman tells you about a lady, you have to listen. You get the point? When a man tells you about a man, you have to listen. When your husband tells you about a man, how men behave, don't argue with him. You get the point? It's what men think when it comes to women. So if a man tells you this man, be very careful with him. Don't try to say, you know what, you can't handle it. You can't. Because the devil has bringing that man or woman to you has went to study your blood lineage. They know how they want to come. They will mess you up. So what do you quickly want? You quickly adjust yourself and hear instruction and what and correct yourself. It's very important. I was saying to myself, the Holy Ghost yesterday said, if you can point finger to yourself, God won't point at you anymore. If you can point finger to yourself, God won't point at you anymore. That's why I teach you that if you point one finger, four points to you. So learn how to point yourself first before pointing other fingers. Learn how to point yourself first fingers. It will, when you do that, it will be difficult for you to sin. Because you always first correct yourself. That's why you watch me this ministry. Before I get upset with you, it takes a long time, a very long time. When I told them I want to leave Salatan to here, they thought I was joking. Why? When I said, once I move, I'm gone. I give long, very long, it can be 4 or 5 years. I just take that thing from you for a long time. You know why? Because I believe that people have areas where they are working on. They need time to work on it. So I keep praying for them. But if you are not in the spirit, you can't alter that area. You need the Holy Ghost. Even as a pastor, there are things you cannot stop for yourself except the Holy Ghost helps you to do. You get it? Some pastors have been struggling with lying spirit, and they are in the altar. Some struggle with fornication. I mean adultery. You get the point? Or lust. So these things are there. But he said, I know you are doing, I love your service towards me, but this area, please correct it very far before. So repent here and correct it before I do something wrong with you. Hallelujah. 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 So there is an arm on the wicked. But whatever he does to you, God says, well, there's a day for him. Hallelujah. Read for me, continue. Hallelujah.
The wicked have drawn out the sword and have bent their bow to cast down the poor and needy and to slay such as be of upright conversation.
I hear what I'm saying. Continue.
Their sword shall enter into their own heart.
Hallelujah.
And their bows shall be broken. Mm-hmm. A little that a righteous man has is better than the riches of many wicked.
Did you hear that?
For the arms of the wicked shall be broken.
Okay, go back. One, two, let's take something together. One, two, something, one, two, go.
For the arms of the wicked shall be broken.
There is
but
what?
The Lord.
Continue.
But the Lord upholded the righteous.
It's okay. For the arms, not one, of the wicked, what shall be broken? If it's not broken, it will work in your life. If you don't break the arm of wickedness from your family lineage, in fact, the worst one is one that comes from your family lineage. Not the one you see maybe in church or see in your neighborhood. The first problem you can have is from family. From mother's side, brother's side, that's where the real problem is coming from. Once you can be free from where you're coming from, I'm telling you, it's difficult to bring you down. Once you can be free from your source, they can't bring you down anymore. Once you can be free from there. So you need to command blessing from the source. From the source. One day God told me, go home and tell your father to bless you, your dad. I'm talking about obeyed because later I passed on. I went to meet him, I bought wine, and that day he was praying for me, blessing me, and was crying. I won't forget that very day. So I have that parental blessing, and you cannot alter it. You get the point? So I have biological blessing from mother and father, from their mouth with all their soul and the crying and pouring blessing. And I also have from my father-in-law, which is when he laid hands on me, I saw a seed on his forehead. And God said, I thought it was, and I was thinking that this man is not a man of God. I was saying, this man, they say, this man is true, he's a locating man. God said to me, but he said to you that as he's teaching, what you will see, you become it. He said that the seed of what? Dominion. That's what it is. So each time I'm in trouble and I say, my name is Magnus, I am the son of the prophet of Richard Paul. And what happened? The thing will move. I'll feel the movement of my friend. What does it mean? It means I tell you the thing is still there. That's what he's telling you. When I went to a program one day, I came back from the program. Papa came the same night. He said to me, I've placed so much on you. Very careful where you go to. Now, the man is a Holy Ghost man, but there are things, there are certain things your father says no. He has the reason for that. If he says don't go, don't go. That's the reason for that. And I said, no. I stopped that one. And the man's anointed. I know the man's a Holy Ghost, I know, but there's a reason. You will know later why he says you shouldn't go there yet. Hallelujah. Maybe there will be time you say, okay, you cannot go for that, but for now, you stay back. There is the arm of the wicked. That's why we need the hand of God. And most times, it begins from your family lineage. It's not what you see when you came to Lagos. You know, those are normal people you met. The real problem is always coming from your lineage. If you can handle your root, you will shine. The people that we met here in Lagos, they just met. Which did you meet them? Which did I meet you, Francis? Which did I meet you? Those are just very, very things. The real problem is from the home. When did I meet Daddy Jasmine? So the real problem, if you can tackle your foundation, you are free. That's why I say, man of God, after all, like this, to the ground. My brother told me, I was praying for you that very day. As I came back from Cana, he opened the gate for me by 12. I didn't tell him I was coming. He said, I know you're coming because I saw the dream where you fell, others off. So I said, God, it can happen. So if I've off, what happened? Others have off. Say every arm of wickedness from my lineage, father and mother side, they are broken in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Once those walls are broken, you are free. Once those walls are broken, you are free. Once those walls from your father and mother side is truly broken, they can't bring you down. You are free. You are free. Oh, that's what they also are very, very things. So, yeah, you the crazy, the mad. These are nonsense now. Those things, they are the effect of the foundation. The reason why you have clash is because of the foundation. For example, now you're supposed to be the next pastor. Eh? You start the choir come. You don't. So, are you getting the point? Maybe you're supposed to be the next manager. It is the same foundation that's giving you that problem. It's not even the manager. Once it's time for manager to lift you up, so, while I will come, just to keep you there. Your challenge is not your neighbor. If you can tell God, let your hand hit my foundation, shatter, destroy the hand of the wicked there, and bring me out of a place of security. One day you're going to be up. You'll be up. When did you meet? When did you come to Lagos? That is your problem. How is it possible? Now, every issue from your lineage that is still working against you, they are caused anymore. Hallelujah. He said, the arm must be broken, or else this will go wrong. Even when you came to, it is then they came to check the place from your village and check the covens around and communicate with the covens around. This guy, we know him. Don't mind him. Don't mind him. Do this. It is coming from that side. That's where it comes from. One day, the guy I told you that had 13 million, he just told me something. Breakthrough, 33 million breakthrough. That young man, I told you, in Abuja. Now, he was telling me, I was praying for him. He said to me, I had a dream one day. I don't understand. As I went close to a river in my area, in my place, as I wanted to put my hand under the river like this, I saw a movement. Pastor, that thing there, if that thing comes from that place, it was kind of everywhere we destroy. The thing I feel there was under that place, so that's the problem. He's telling you that if you're near here, you are dead. I said, no, that one is serious. What do you do? Do what they call separation, because you can't fight this one. He's telling you that the movement means that this, if you come here, you better go your own. Leave others. You better go your own. I tell that guy, listen, look, if I have slept with your wives in this place or your daughters in this land, it will work. If I've not, if you raise that thing up against me, both the staff and you are dead. Because so the earth knows me. This earth knows me. No, if you say the earth knows me, anywhere you go to say Magna the earth, because he has received things from me for over the years, he knows me. As if I've slept with your wives, your children, this place, but if not, you are dead. If you raise that thing, what do you want? You are dead. You don't speak. You speak from a condition. You don't talk anyhow. You talk from a stand. You don't talk. There's people you talk to. As I told you, as a pastor, they will fire you straight. You know that many doctors you are talking to. They are finishing your kid. They are finishing you already, because they know you are a paper. You are just nothing. You are nothing. You're just talking. But if you are talking from a platform, they will know. Every arm of wickedness from your lineage, they they are cursed anymore. Hallelujah. So all the trouble you see among your friends, this is not the problem. Those are the effect of what from the place. They have come around you again, say, they have come to your area, so they know all the people. They just stop up everywhere. Anything that bring, they fight everything that feel, everything, fight everything. When they start with to enjoy the thing, they start fighting it. It's not the people, it is your foundation. It is your roof that is the problem. You're going to pray for the hand of God. You know what is your prayer, prayer, hand of God, my life. I just say, when the hand of God comes, it destroys. It destroys yokes. It does. Now, the hand of the wicked manifests in these following ways. It will manifest to bring barrenness. Poverty, lack and wealth. Stagnation. All these things are the effect of the oppression, the arm of wickedness. What is arm? Power. Because God has what is plan of power. So arm still means what? Power. To do wicked to you. Every hand who do wicked in life, they cause them all to hallelujah. Mostly from your root, your foundation. Your father, mother side. Hey, see. There are things your parents can't tell you. They think you cannot handle it. That is, I was supposed to have my ask mother, ask her. You get the point? And I was, why did you not tell me this thing? Or if you, they think you are too small. They see you like a baby. So you are the one to discover and speak. One day, I told my father something. I asked him, he was shocked. So I stopped talking to him. I started going to the village straight to myself. One day, I went to the village. I came back. He said to me, in my language, say he went to the village. I said, no. He said he went to the village. I said, no. He said he went to the village. I said, no. I said, okay. But I went there. I strictly came back. Nobody saw me there. Nobody saw me in the farm. I came to the farm there and engaged the brother. I came back. I said, this man is think I'm still a baby. Not that he's hiding something like that. But he feels you can't handle it. Before you now go and do what will kill you, you get this. And because he likes you as a son, he doesn't want you to kill you. It's better for him to die than you die. So that's why, not that he really hates. So he doesn't know that you have passed the realm without. I've received something when I saw Papa's forehead. Something entered me. When I saw his forehead. So when that man said he want to curse me, I said, no, it's not possible. There are sons of the prophet. There are sons like Polininchi. There are sons like Ibiume. These are sons. There are also sons like Bishop Aremu. There are sons like Papa's biological son. There are sons like Bishop Yeri. There are sons. These ones, they occupy a class of his sonship. Because they have had contact with him. They've mingled. There are just like this man, what's called Absalom. David was crying because he knew the man was gonna die. Because he knew the Bible said, touch not my anointed. So he knew his son will die because he's fighting the oil. The father lost the son, but the son is fighting the oil of God upon David. So what David is crying, David is not crying because David knows that what this guy is fighting is oil. He doesn't know. So they're deceiving him. What happened? The God of the oil, what took him by the lock, and he died between the air and the land. And David cried. You know why? Absalom was the true son of David. You know, a warrior likes a warrior son. So Absalom was handsome, beautiful, and a warrior. David loved him, but the guy didn't know that he was fighting not the father, but the oil upon the father. So he was destroyed. That is your pressure of the arm of the wicked. Satan entered that family. When David slept with what? That lady. And Saul entered there. Kili entered that place. It was a lineage problem. From the home, from the family. From the father. It was called from the father. So I began to go myself. I didn't tell him. After a while, he now found that I've passed. I'm not a child. When your father look at you, when they look at me like this, he just smiled. That's why he began to send me to the village sometimes. He had not known, this man is no more my God. I tell them, if I go, I tell them, I'm not Ile, my father's name. My name is Magnath. I used to tell them, my name is not Ile. No, my name is Magnath. So my father lived this one is a different person altogether. So if you don't take care of this one, you're going to have a problem. I went to my father's burial and I got there. When they went to call the man, there's no king there in my place. The oldest man is the king. Once you're older, you're older. The man was coming, his leg was in the air. So when you want to bend down like this, they'll just hit you. Because if you bend down, what you see will shock you. What you will see, who is he coming? You don't see the person coming. What you will see coming will shock you. That's what I mean. So the thing is, by the time he stood, when they sat for the elders meeting, for me to give them, and you give them, I said, I can't do. So I brought mineral. I said, this mineral is already communion. They did this communion. None of that. If they fight me, the communion will be inside of them, finishing them. So I took, I blessed it. As I was, they said, okay, come. That means it's time for me to come and stand for the man now. That elder. As I was coming to do like this, the man slept for 1 second. The man slept. He slept for 1 second. So he bowed like this. So they hit him, bam! But he slept and bowed. Because he dozed for just a second. He dozed. I know that man dozed. I'm scared of him. Bam! The guy came like this. He like this, looked at me. He has already bowed. Because God said to me, the day your village agreed that the oldest man will be the God, the leader, they made me the leader of that place. The day they agreed, when the elders agreed that the oldest person will become the leader, that's what they made me the leader. They don't know. So he said, when I say bring blood, you came to install me. I own this place now. You came to install me. That was when my brother had a dream. When he said he saw five princes kneeling down in front of me. Five of them, they knelt down. They were in leprosy, swarm, all kinds. They were scratching, they were screaming, begging me to release them. Five of them. Because God took over. Now, every prince worrying your life from your father's side and mother's side, every siege that they are the real problem. All these things you are seeing in Lagos, see all this while, they are nothing. They are the aftermath of that real problem. So every time you want to get some, they just scatter it. They always want to make sure you don't go down and tell you the truth. But in the name of the Lord, hallelujah. Every such of your home, they are causing him to hallelujah. Why? Upon Zion, what? Deliverance, wholeness. What? You not take what is yours. I want the wicked. We bring problem for your sickness. Why? If you walk charms to bring sickness, blow to the air to bring you sickness, affliction by necromancers. You know, Jesus Christ speaking, he said to them in Matthew 19 or so. He said to them, there are some that are eunuch, like Catholic priests. They don't marry eunuchs. They say they want to be eunuch by themselves. See, there are some that are eunuch of men. That is a man in your village said nobody can get married in your village. Nobody go marry for that. Nobody go marry for that family. Nobody. The man sees them, stays there in the village and bring the remote walking charms, making incantation is the arm of wickedness. That arm is broken in the name of hallelujah. Is the arm of wickedness. Is the arm that broken in the name of hallelujah. When the arm operates, it makes you toil the whole night. Peter toil. It's not the same man that goes to fish every time. Why would he know that there's no fish this time? But the thing was removed. There was an operation of wickedness. It's not against him that very day. He could do it. It toiled the whole night. So if the arm is there, what happened? You toil. The arm, or you can miss to toil. You struggle. That's what we call vain labor. But the word say he has not called the seed of Jacob seeking in vain. Every operation available in your life, they are caused in the name of hallelujah. But when the end of God came, what happened? This changed. You know why? In 1 Kings 8, verse 15, it says, and Solomon said that the things God said to my father, his hand brought to pass. the things God said to my father David, his hand has what brought it to pass. So when Peter was toiling, Jesus said, give what a word, Abby. How did it come to pass? By the hand of God. Because each time the word comes, it is the horse hand that bring it to pass. So your toiling will not end except by the hand of God. The arm of the wicked makes you tall, vulnerable. What if vulnerable means, if your office, what in concern your boss if they sack you? What is, something worked it out for them to sack you. Something worked it out. Okay, someone say, I'll give you 1 million. He said, I won't give you again. Something worked it out. It's not the man that has the money. Something worked it out. Something worked it out. That means cause anymore to hallelujah. Say enough is enough, hallelujah. That's what you bring my life, bring your life in the name of hallelujah. There is a hand on the wicked, it makes you toil like Peter toiled. But when the word came, what happened? God's hand came on board. Because what God speaks, his hand brings to pass. When he says cast to the right side, he obeyed. What happened? God's hand. He said, when they have this done, what happened? They moved. Harm, because that action means they believe the word. Who has believed the report? Then what happened? God's hand is not meant for to bring to pass the word. So when Peter believed, what happened? God's hand moved to bring to pass the words of Christ. I say to you today, everything fighting your life, making you to toil all day, they are caused in the name of hallelujah. They are caused in the name of hallelujah. The arm of the wicked. That woman gave birth. They said, did you give birth to the nose? That's barrenness. How did you, that is, they have worked some things out that they cannot give birth. Bible says the Lord in Job 5:12, he disappointed the token device of the Lord, they cannot perform. So if God's hand does not come, they will perform the enterprise. So they perform on that woman and say, you cannot give birth. To the one of my auntie I prayed for. Eh? And now from son said, go to the coven. I took his baby from the coven, gave it to her. And the next day, he said to me, he had a dream that he had three apples. Three apples, is that not children? He said, as I left in that dream, he said, somebody knocked. It was the one I saw in that coven. And took the apple from her and began to eat the apple again. That's the end of the, you know? That is the arm of the wicked. They walk barrenness that you can't understand. Whatever makes you burn, they are caused anymore. Hallelujah. They are caused anymore. Hallelujah. The arm wicked works barren. We went to UI that time, and I told you I told Aaron to sleep, the other guy to sleep, and they had dreams when I was praying over them for two hours. So I woke them up and said, what did you see in the dream? Aaron said that he saw when we were coming from that UI, that river, into that going to winner's office. He said, we stood there in that vision. Just the way we came in the daytime, we stood there, but an old man, very old, came out from the water and stood and was speaking their language. Aaron is from Ibadan. Aaron is from Kor Yoruba, those Ibadan. So he was saying, he was speaking that, he said, that kind of Yoruba is speaking, not everybody can hear it. He was speaking Kor. So he was not telling me that what your fathers can do, you are trying to achieve it. You are dead. See, as he tries to strike the rod, Aaron said, I grabbed his hand, I broke the rod on his hand. Is that Aaron? No, that's the angel of God. If you don't break his arm, you can't have that problem in that place. So when we finish that now, release the blood, the dogs were crying. They were expressing the pain of the man because he has lost control in this way. And for about 5-6 years, there was no record of fraternity work in USC. I noticed that for almost from that time, 2004, to very long time, there was a silence in cutting schools. A very long time, there was a silence. Maybe because we didn't go by that time, there was, and I didn't know that UI was the first school. I said, UI is very, and I asked, okay, UI said the first. So we went to the foundation of the universities to water it. You recall, I had a vision before we get there. Eh? In that vision, I saw sacks of blood on the ground, sacks of blood on the ground, and I saw men like zombies. He said, the zombies are men who have been killed by fraternity, and the sack of blood is what? It's aborted children. the campus, and they are crying against those who killed them, that they won't leave school. If they leave school, they'll be vagabonds, and they can't get a job. So from school, there's a cry against them. So the gate is shut. They can't graduate. Some stay in school for more than 8 years, for a course of 4 years. It's a block crying against them. So you say you are coming to say they should keep quiet. That's why they're not happy. So it took us 3 years. We don't have program in UI. But I saw it and went to engage from the gate, and he opened up for us. Now, by the power in the blood, that thing you must do or get that is yours yet to come, take the name of Jesus, hallelujah. Take the name of Jesus, my blood, hallelujah. By the blood, we enter and had the program done. Receive the name of Jesus, hallelujah. Where there's arm of the wicked, there's arm of God. And most times, if the arm of the wicked exists, there must be someone that can deliver from the arm, or you can't stay, you stay there forever. So there is the hand of God. Habakkuk 3 verse 4, it says there is the hiding of what? His power. The hand of the wicked make you toil. It bring barrenness, shame and reproach, all kinds. That's why I say, he said that, that's Psalm 74 verse 11 and 12. He said, Lord, how long shall they reproach us? Bring out your hand to God. If your family has been reproached all these years, they are free in the name of Jesus, hallelujah. They are free in the name of Jesus, hallelujah. The hand of God will come down by prayers. So in a month like this, we pray down the hand of God. Now, say it's a month of what answer prayer, what fullness of joy. I said that these things cannot happen except by the hand of God. You cannot have answer prayer and joyfully without the hand of God. One, and look at, let me give you a few points. Number one, faith brings down the hand of God, for your testimony that brings you joy in fullness. Because if you have testimony, you have joy. You see, in John 16:24, hitherto you have not asked me, ask that you may receive, that your joy be full. In other words, when you ask and it's answered, you'll be happy. So now, how will your answer come? It is linked to the hand of God. In Isaiah 50, the Bible says, who has believed what our report? So if you have faith in your prayer, what happened? It will bring what? Testimony. How? It will bring the hand of God. Who has faith? That's what it means. To that one, what happens? God's hand is all revealed, like that of Peter when he was toiling, and brought the change of abundance in his life. So answer prayer comes by a prayer of faith that will move God's hand to get done. But how will faith come? It said, beloved, praying always in the Holy Ghost. Beloved, build up your most holy, Jude 1:20, building up your most holy faith. What? Praying in the Holy Ghost. Men ought to pray on the faith. So if you don't pray, you faint. How do you faint? But if you don't pray, you destroy your wall of faith. Because prayer builds the wall of faith. Bible said in Ephesians 5:12-10, he said, taking the shield of faith to quench all the darts of the enemies. So if your faith is brought down, the darts will hit you hard. You will faint. If the walls of faith is broken, the darts will hit you hard. So your faith raises up what? A wall against the adversary of your life. Let those who are coming from your home. Your faith raises what? A wall against your enemies of your life, to bring you what? To a place where you are secured. So you don't fail anymore. So you fail because the walls are down of faith. So the enemies will have access to you to break you down and get you weak. So answer prayer comes by faith. And faith comes by prayer. So and faith brings the hand of God. So you need answer prayer. What is linked to what? The hand of God. Maybe that is what the name of Jesus, hallelujah. So when you pray in faith, you bring hand of God in your life, which brought turn the issue to testimony for your joy to be full. Your joy to be full today in the name of Jesus, hallelujah. Number two, everyone is in the world is a pit. You know, the Bible says, talking about Egypt. You know, the Egypt also means the world. Abi, now it says in Genesis 13 verse 1, it says, and Abraham came up out of what? Egypt. So Egypt is a pit. And Egypt means what? The world system, Abi, which means everyone in the world not born again is in the pit. So So, but in Zechariah 9:11-12, it says, as for thee also, by the blood, I will bring you out of the pit. Without what? What that means? Out of what pit of test? What's test? Hell. Hell means test. So it means that by when you are born again, you are brought out from the pit without water, that's hell, to what? To sit with him in heavenly places. It means that now for you to be saved, don't you pray sinner's prayer? So prayer is needed to bring the hand of God to deliver from the pit of sin, the one to righteousness. So this month, prayer remains the key roundabout. Prayer will make faith rise. For the God to bring results in your life, prayer will bring the hand of God down to bring you out of the pit as a sinner. What for instance, you can't be saved except by sinners' prayers. So you pray for the hand of God to come. As you pray, may God's hand come on your life in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Now, so prayer will bring the hand of God into our situations. Hallelujah. Let's look at 1 Kings 18. We saw Elijah. He said to them, this rain has not become, but it's going to come now. Elijah went to pray. He said to someone, 1 Kings 18, I think from verse 40 or so, he said to someone, go and look at the sky as I'm praying. He was praying, the guy was going to check. After a while, he said, I see a kind of hand. You get the point? You remember Zechariah 10 verse 1, he says, ask of me rain. What happened? I will make bright clouds with my hand. In other words, when you pray, when Elijah prayed, God's hand came out to me bright cloud. He said to this guy, wrong, for I hear the sound of what? Abundance of rain. Why? God's hand brings the rain of his blessings by prayers. So in this month, what do you expect? His blessings. See, my Father, my God, this month I receive your flowing of your blessing. Say, this month I receive your flowing of God's blessing upon my life. So when you pray, you command his hand of blessing. It brings down the rain, which you call later from my rain upon your life. That's Joel 2 from verse 23. God's hand brings down the rain of blessing that alters the life of good. If you have blessing, what happens? You will prosper. You see, it is what? God's blessing that make her rich and add what? No sorrow. So God's hand comes down. How? To bring blessing. What blessing do? Blessing will destroy the arm. How? It will make the curse turn to blessing. All the arm of God does is to quench the works of the arm of wickedness in your life. And when you are blessed, what happened? The thing that destroyed. He said, in Exodus 23 verse 5, he says, for the Lord your God loved thee and turned the curse to blessing. Exodus 23 verse 5. The Lord your God did hear to Balak. Who is Balak? The wicked. Who is Balaam, the wicked? So God say, I didn't hear him because what? I love you, and I turn his curse to blessing. In other words, when you are blessed by God's hand, you destroy the work of wickedness in your life. Hallelujah. See, my Father, my God, by God's blessing today, hallelujah, every work of wickedness in my life is destroyed. Hallelujah. 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 So God's hand was a miracle. You saw in the pool of Bethesda, many were there. Jesus Christ said to him, will you be made whole? John 5:2-5 and 6. We saw a man there who had been there for 38 years. Jesus touched him. What happened? He was made whole. Why? His hand is what? Is the hand that breaks the work of wickedness in your life. Hallelujah. The guy was bound 38 years wickedness, but by the hand of God was freed. You are free in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. 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 In Matthew 20:34. Now, the hand of God is the hand of Jesus Christ. I mean, Jesus Christ came as the image of God. So, his hand is God's express hand in people's life. You get the point? You know, he touched this woman, Peter's wife's mother. What happened? Because the hand of God is the hand of Jesus Christ. Now, read from Matthew 20:34.
Praise the Lord. Matthew 20:34. So Jesus had compassion on them and touched their eyes, and immediately their eyes received sight and they followed him.
There was wickedness there of blindness, but the hand of God changed. Hallelujah. Everything that blocks your vision in life, that you cannot see, you can't vision, no dream, nothing. you can't see your future. Whatever blocks your future, they are gone. In the name of Jesus, hallelujah. Jesus touched him and was free, hallelujah. Take your sight, in the name of Jesus, hallelujah. Now, if the hand of God is this powerful, miracle testimonies, you saw it, destroy toiling. How did he do it? The word came, the hand got the power. Because is it, what God says is hand brings the power. So Peter had the hand of God brought those things to pass for him. Because what God says is a hand that brings it to pass. So when Jesus Christ said, cast you onto the right side, he obeyed. God's hand brought those fish to pass. So if God's hand can end toiling, end barrenness, then we must know how to get in our lives, hallelujah. How do I make God's hand come on my life? How do I stop God's hand? We take these few words, hallelujah. Number one, for God's hand to be operating in your life, you must want live a sanctified life. Sanctified life. Isaiah 51:9 verse 1 and 2 says, my hand is not too short, I cannot heal, but your sins has made me not to act on your life. So the sin from our roots, you get the point? What a sin. Sin of what? Idol worship. All those things miss God, hate family lineage. Your son. So he sees you, he sees your father in you. He hates your father for idol. So the hatred come to you until you got born again. So that iniquity makes his hand withdraw. That's why some families have sickness, nothing at all. They all kinds, because God's hand is in the bosom, because angry with their father that worship idols. Idols. So we have to sanctify what our foundation for God's hand to work in life, hallelujah. Say today, by the blood today, hallelujah, I'm sanctified today, hallelujah, and by the word of God also, I am cleansed in the name of Jesus, hallelujah. Bible said in John 15:3, ye are clean by what? The things I've spoken to you, hallelujah. So the word of God coming to you, sanctify you for God's hand to come on you. It comes to you. John 17:17. Sanctify them with the word. That word is what? True. So you need the word of God to sanctify you, to make you free from those bondage. Number two, prayers. Elijah prayed down the hand of God. 1 Kings 18:41-45. He said to someone, go and watch for me. You don't stop praying until the hand of God comes. Elijah kept praying until the hand of God came upon him and altered his life for good. The rain that couldn't fall began to fall. Today, God's hand is coming upon you in your life, hallelujah. And you're going to have a real blessing in the name of Jesus, hallelujah. See, my Father, my God, I receive your good hand upon my life that bring the rain of a blessing upon my life, hallelujah. So Elijah prayed and God rained down the blessing that altered life for good, hallelujah. Number three, you need meekness to bring down the hand of God. Meekness. 1 Peter 5:6 says what? Humble yourself under what? His good hand. In due course. So there's the good hand of God, but you need to be humble under it for it to work in your life. I believe by this communion, as you take Bible says communion is to purge our conscience. Mark 7 talked about the things in the heart. Out of our heart proceed evil thoughts, pride. All those things defile our heart. But by the communion, we can purge our heart from them, for God's hand to come upon us. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So we need meekness. Meekness. James 4:10 says what? The Lord God resists the proud. And it's what? More grace. What? To them, what's grace? Grace means the hand of God upon your life. The things that make you do the impossible in your life. So number one, sanctification. Number two, prayers can bring God's hand upon your life. Number three, your meekness can attract God's hand upon your life. If you are meek, you will get God's hand upon you. And of course, number four, it takes the blood to bring down his hand. You saw them in Egypt. In Exodus 3, he said to them in 19, he said, I know Pharaoh will let you go. He will not release you. But not by what? A mighty hand. That means the time my hand will come, what happened? He will let you go. That means God's hand has power to deliver. But he has to confess. Now they engage all kinds of signs on it. They only had his finger working. Hallelujah. He said, I'll bring one more plague. Have you not? And he shall let you go. And that plague brought down his hand. How? When the blood came, their sins were purged. Their iniquities were cleansed. And that brought down the hand of God. Because God says, as long as there's sin, man can manifest. So their sin kept God's hand away for those years. But when the blood came, they became free. by the community today, you are free in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. That sin that will let God's hand come on you, they are purged in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. That sin is purged in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Now again, what can bring God's hand down? We said it earlier, is faith. Hallelujah. Faith brings God's hand down upon us. That's clear in Isaiah 53 verse 1 and Luke 1:45. Luke 1:45 says, blessed is them that believe it. What happened? Did that mean what? A performance of what they believe. That's it. So when Peter believed Jesus Christ, what happened? The hand of God went and performed that miracle for him. He was packing abundance. You pack such the name of Hallelujah. So faith is paramount or needed for us to enjoy what? The hand of God. Hallelujah. 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 Evangelism also qualifies for that. God knowing that you cannot evangelize without power. So once you are set for evangelism, he will empower you. Once you are ready to go to evangelize, God will empower you. So it's a means to attract the hand of God and his face in your life. He said in Acts 1:8, and ye shall receive power. What happened? Holy Ghost come upon you, and you can be my witness. So you cannot witness it by power, and that power come by the hand of God. So if you are set to evangelize, what happened? God what? Put his hand upon you for power. If you are set to preach the gospel, his main assignment, he will empower you. Once you go on the go, you know what I'm saying? As they went, they were cleansed. You know? As they went, they were cleansed. You know why? Just guys, those guys who have turned out leprosy, he said, go and meet the priest. He said, as they went, they were cleansed. Why? When they obey their faith, they obey what happened. The hand of God came along and cleansed them up. But each time you obey God's word, you put God's hand into action. So, evangelism means to obey his instruction. What happened? He will empower you to get it done. So, each time you are set to evangelize, you receive divine hand of God for empowerment. Receive the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. God's hand is very powerful. Hallelujah. There is nothing that can stand when it comes to your life. Now, if this hand comes to you, what's going to happen to you? Number one, there will be lifting. Hallelujah. If God's hand comes to you, what happened? There will be lifting in your life. Hallelujah. Nothing can hold you down anymore. He said, I asked for thee, but Lord, I brought thee out of the pit. God's hand brings lifting. Ezekiel 8:108. He says, and I saw a kind of hand. That's Ezekiel was speaking. He said, took me by the head, my head, and raised me up. That fulfills Psalm 113:7-8. He raised up the poor from the dust to make them sit with princes. That's elevation. So God's hand comes to lift you up when it comes. So if you can do these things that will make his hand come upon your life, what happened? You'll experience what I'm talking about now. You have seen what the hand of God can do. Eh? Now you don't know what to do to bring the hand of God. If you can bring God's hand upon your life, this is what you're going to experience. One is divine liftings. Ezekiel was just sitting down, don't know what happened. God's hand came and picked him from the head and raised him up. And he saw signs and wonders. You will see signs in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah, your life. So when the hand of God comes to you, it is designed to raise you up. In Psalm 147:6, it says, the Lord lift up the meek. You hear that? The Lord lift up the meek and casted the wicked to the ground. Did you hear that? He will cast what? Wicked to the ground. To the ground. That's how he brings the hand. He raises you up. Psalm 147:6, the Lord lift up the meek. What? Cast down wicked to the ground. See, my Father, my God, by your hand, O God, all wickedness against my life and this commission, they are cast down to the ground. Hallelujah. That's what God says is going to happen to you when your hand comes. Receive the name of God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Number two, when the hand of God comes on your life, it will bring divine power manifestation. Hallelujah. Power manifests in your life. Habakkuk 3:4. It says, there's brightness from his hand, horns on his hand. There is the hiding of his what? Power. So God's hand carries his power. Hallelujah. And of course, 1 Kings 8:15 says, whatever God tells you happen, his hand has power enough to bring it to pass. 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 He said, you prosper me yet. So it's going to come to pass in your life. The name of Jesus. Hallelujah. So he brings power when he comes. That power will break the arm of what? Wickedness and make you free. It breaks it. You know, he said, I saw 4 horns, I'll be 4 horns. Now, God's hand carries what? 7 horns, I'll be. So when you have his hand on you, all the Gentiles' horn are humiliated. Ezekiel 36 verse 7 says, I've raised man. Eh? What happened? The heathens, what? Will bear that. Why? Because my hand will destroy the obstacles on your life and give glory and honor. That horn that is making you not to have blessings, it will be destroyed by the seven horn of his hand. So when the hand of God comes to you with seven horns, it will destroy the four of the Gentiles. So it will end the reproach of the Gentiles. Say, my Father, my God, I receive your hand, hallelujah, upon this commission in my life, O God. And every horn of Gentiles, give me reproach in any form. That's on the name of God, hallelujah. When it comes, it will end the reproach of the Gentiles because it will free their horn from your life, hallelujah. They are free in the name of God, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Expect the reign of what? His seven spirits. Hallelujah. Expect the reign of what? God's seven spirit upon your life. You hear that in Habakkuk 3 verse 4. His hand carries his horn of power. Revelation 5 verse 6 says what? The seven horns with seven eyes are what? His Holy Spirit. Abi? So those horns and eyes are the seven spirit of God. So when they come on you, carry what? His seven spirit. That turns to a God on earth. That's the fullness of God. So when a hold of hand come on you, you become the fullness of God on earth. You manifest as sons of God. Hallelujah. So I see grace in the name of God. Hallelujah. To manifest as sons in the name of God. Hallelujah. So you have that empowerment by when it happens. Expect every Moab to go down. Who are Moab? Balaam. And his main people. Balaam, Moab, those who hire men to curse you. Moabites are those who hire men to curse you. Who lie to men to release wars against you. You know that if you come to me now, there's a way you talk to me. If I didn't pray very well, I might release a curse on the wrong person. Maybe you're not happy with the person. And maybe it's your family member. And maybe you now came, you didn't tell me the details. Just say the way that I just picked it from you and release a curse on the person. You get the point? Now, the danger is this. If I release that curse on that young person, if he's a Christian, maybe there was a quarrel, normal quarrel, and the curse hits him, goes to the guy. If the person has if the curse gets there, and they judge that the person should not be destroyed, the curse will return back to the pastor. When it comes back to the pastor, it can't hurt the pastor because the pastor is bigger than the curse. What happens? It goes back to the person. So if you report a man that's stronger than you in authority, you're going to have problems. Even a little doctor that you brought case against, if you are living in sin, it's a problem. Because if the man of God releases that power against him, he might fall. But if he survives and you go back to sin, you are finished. So if a man of God releases a curse, the curse can't kill himself. No. But if now you want, you know, you tell them to make it, you communicate right wrongly, for the cause to go to that person, it will come back good to you. Why? Because the angels will not say, when the angels sit and check the things going on, they say, you lied, you didn't tell the man of God true. That's why he put the answer, which means, and they can't go to that. So, you get the point? Except he also is told he will not destroy the cause by himself. You get the point? That's why Papa said to you that there are different men of God. Men of God means they are pastors. There are some who are prayer warriors. You know, there are some prayer warriors that are very strong as pastors. Have you ever seen that? Some church prayer warriors, leaders, they are very powerful. You see, those who do it in purity. Some prayer warriors are very strong. You see, those who do it with what? Righteousness. So for you to begin to fight that kind of person is a problem. Are you getting the point? Because we're all God's children, Abi. So he takes our case and weighs it. But no matter how you are God's children, I cannot fight Papa, and it can't work now. So that's how it is. That's how it works. Hallelujah. Receive his name. Hallelujah. Now the point is, if you are empowered, it's for good works only. Hallelujah. So you must know who you are, who you are praying against. Be very careful you pray against. You get the point? Pray the right prayers. Hallelujah. Let God take his course. Hallelujah. Now, Moabites are those who hire men to curse you. So, if they hire men to curse you, what happens? Only God can change that, baby. Only God can change it. So, Balaam was told to speak the words I put in your mouth. For Israel is my own. I have blessed them. Hallelujah. 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 Now, Faith Tabernacle has only one commandment to this church. You get the point? It's for blessings. Why? Because of your tithe, your offerings, and Shiloh sacrifice. I went that day to drop Shiloh one day. One of the pastors from this local churches was shocked when he saw the amount. It's not what you put here that will go and drop there. It's not what you contribute here. Maybe well, at the end, maybe teacher will call that 50,000 naira. That's not what finally gets there. No. It's not. That is above it. Above it. So, when the guy saw what we're giving at Shiloh, he said, which church? Konfola Church. He said, which church? He said, Alagu. Which Alagu? So, the guy was trying to find which was Alagu. He said, no, it's Konfola Church. It's okay. I told you the winners. So, but it was a seed. So, the angel knows the church. You are a son, not by a member. This church now, that we are all sons. Eh? But you are really a son by what? Your commitment. By your tithing, your record offering. That's what makes a son. So if I stand between you Una, and Papa, eh? The angel will check what I've dropped on the altar and what you have dropped. Are you getting the point? That's how it works. They don't check that this one is the provincial pastor or this one. They check when they come in authority, you are provincial pastor. But when it comes to the blessing or the order, you are smaller because of what you're giving. So the value of this church is equal to some winners' churches around the world. Because some of them don't even pay to the center. They hardly pay that kind of money to the center. That's why so this church occupies a realm. Which realm? It's the provincial realm. I was praying one day and I saw myself in Kenya, and there was pastors meeting going on, and Papa was calling out provincial pastors. I wasn't the member of the church. I was already there. So he called my name. See, these are the, they said there are seven provincial pastors that are going to call up now for this different locations of the of this. So he called. He was calling them. When he called me, I was telling my friend, I'm not a winner, so why are you calling my name now? He said, so they called me, the third time, and I came out, stood at the throne. So we stood around the altar, we were seven of us, and we ordained as provincial pastors. Now, it means that's the realm the church occupies in his heart. It's a provincial level. You know provincial level in the winners? It's a very high level. So it is not your coming to this church. It is what how you are committed that differentiates you as a son or a member. Hallelujah. So that altar has only one command to this church, is to bless. So Balak was giving sacrifice to alter what? The one that Jacob has given. He said, no, what Jacob has given to me is too much. No, so even if you give 10 bullets, he can't handle it. He said, so God went and put in his mouth what? Blessing. He was told to curse, but God came and put what his mouth because the person involved. Why? He cannot be cursed. He can't be cursed at all. He can't be cursed. I told you last week, I want to pray for you now. Last week, suddenly I started having visions of, I was seeing vision, picture of how I was dropping, things I dropped in Canaan altar. Some shoes, some, I told you now, I was just seeing those. I said, why am I seeing all this now? I used to drop in that altar. He said, there's a remembrance coming up. The remembrance coming up. I was seeing that the shoes, I can't count the suits. I can't count the shoes. Those shoes are not fairly usual. They are brand new shoes that I didn't wear. Inside the offering box like that. I can't count them. Is it the money? Is it my taste? Is it my seat? Is it my laptop? I can't count them. What have you given to the altar? What you have? What the pastor? What have you given? And you're commanding blessing for that. It doesn't work that way. And you say they should curse somebody else. It's not so it can't work. I should curse my son. I said, imagine your son that is in Abuja. Once in the US. You went in Abuja, send you money. Is that not better? It's a pity house for you. Give you that. He said they should curse him. It's not, it can't work. It's like that one for you, son. And that one day you know, I don't know. But you that are here, I see your seed to me. I see every month my account, my lot come to me. Every month you honor me. You have my honor. What the cause? So if you want to bless, that's how to bless. Don't joke with the altar regards your tithe, your burnt offerings, your first fruit. If you can, first fruit, if you can. It's not easy. Don't joke. If you can, get it all. When the chips are down, I'm telling you, their altar will rise for you. When the chips are down, the altar will rise for you. Because he will see those things in records. What you have done there. One day, we're having a wedding, and of course, my sister's wedding, and things were going wrong. And the drawer opened to me. I saw the shoe I bought, how much? For my sister's wedding. They said, that's the sacrifice for the Sunday. My brother, I took my eyes other place. But I still took it and went to drop in the church. When I dropped that shoe, it paid me. That shoe, I can't tell you the amount I bought it. That this something is, I think it's 2004, maybe, I don't know, it's long now. I dropped it there. One thing I kept, my CD, one of my CD, I like so much. I dropped it there. Is it my TV that Obiora helped me carry? Very big TV, big screen. Not the one we gave to Christ and Messiah. So if we are talking, we are not talking from mouth. You're not saying I'm a winner by mouth or I'm a Comfort Life Church by mouth. Comfort Life Church by mouth, it doesn't work. You must be in choir and be there strongly. If you're not giving money, be in choir and be there strongly. If you're in prayer band, be there strongly. Be there strongly. Be there so that when the chips are down, the altar will rise for you. When you write up, they'll put your word blessing. They can't put cause there because this man is a son. He's a son. You are blessed. Hallelujah. Now today, my God will place an appointment to that lawyer. And he will lift you up, hallelujah. He will empower you, hallelujah. He will empower you, hallelujah. The name of Jesus, hallelujah. So it says that when your hand comes, 1 Samuel 5, verse, he says, and the hand of God was heavy, what? Upon the what? The Philistines. You get the point? Heavy. Heavy. What does it mean? He gave them boil, sicknesses. It was against them. That man from your village, that witch in your lineage, that I'm concerned about your family. I'm not talking about the root cause. Now, as we pray now, every family lineage problems, they are caused in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. That Moabite from your mother's side. That is giving you confusion, making men to hate you. They are not making people to hate you inside Lagos. They are home, they're doing all kinds of things. Now I decree Marokolabia, that wicked uncle, that wicked Jezebel, Marokoba, they are caused anymore to hallelujah. As the hand of God comes to your feet, anymore to hallelujah. So when it comes to silence those that are hired to curse you, it silences them. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. That's what wicked uncles do. That's what they do in the village. They go and go hire authority to place a curse. That's what they do. The guy is confused. He's fighting these people in the office. You are free in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Finally, expect what? To come out of every pit without waters. Every place of stagnation ends today. Hallelujah. It ends today. Hallelujah. As for thee, also by the blood, I brought you out from the pit without waters. When God's hand comes on you, it will lift you up. It will manifest as power to carry the word of God in your life to come to pass. When it comes on you, to rain on you, the Spirit of God for power, for victory. When it comes, it will make the Moabites to bow in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. It will end that curse against your life. Hallelujah. When it comes, it will become painful for your enemies in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. It shall be heavy against your enemies in the name of Jesus. See, my Father, my God. Today, let your hand be heavy against my enemies. Spirit of prophecy, hallelujah. First Samuel 5 verse 6. He said, and the hand of God was heavy against them. Heavy against them. Be on your feet and pray, hallelujah. It's a serious matter. Let your hand be heavy against that witch, that wizard, that occult man. That man in our lineage, in your father and mother's side, let your hand be heavy against them. Let your hand be heavy against them. Malabasore kalabalande, shatwa kayige dorubalande, dem prekosu kalabandaya. Let someone pray the hallelujah. Let your hand be heavy against malosaish. Baya kaluru kalabande. Pray, alas. They keep a cobra calabandish. Then broke up Rakulebaya. Jagaba calabanda thing. Zigibe Cambrokulebalandish. Let your hand be heavy against them, God. Bible said in 1 Samuel Marekulabalas. Mande Kedukulabandish. Mande Kulabasuyasha. 5 and verse 6. He said the hand of God was heavy against the enemies. Mandeku, let your hand be heavy against adversaries. As a church, leaves of God. hand of God was heavy against Moabites. Hallelujah. That trouble Israel. Let your hand be heavy, God. Every gang go from your mother's side and father's side. Majik, let the hand of God be heavy against you, God. Whatever they have done in your village against you, Majik will be destroyed. Hallelujah. Whatever is coming from your line is none. Let the God pray, God. Say, Koso Kalabaya. Say, Father, my God, by your mighty hands, begin to uproot every plantings in my family. That trouble us, hallelujah. Uproot and pray, hallelujah. By your hand, uproot to God. Lord, begin to uproot every plantings of the devil. Occultic plantings in our families of God. That trouble us. Uproot them. Uproot them, Maloka. Uproot them in our families of God. Majek Kalabayan. Visit our families of God. And begin to crush. And begin to crush. Majek Kulebalande. And begin to crush. Mande Kalabonde. Every plantings of the devil. That trouble us to go in our family. Uproot it. Uproot, 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 uproot. By your mighty hands. By your mighty hands. By your mighty hands. Ayakalosos. Uproot them, O God. Every plant of the devil. In this commission, uproot, 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 uproot. Every plantings of devil. This church that trouble us. Uproot them, O God. Be plantings of charms. Let me uproot, O God. Destroy every evil tree, uproot, 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 oh God. Majekulabayan. Everything that trouble our family, God, uproot, 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 by let's, Lord, pluck out your hand, oh God, and uproot them, oh God. Majekulabayan. Is Ezekiel that family altar? Uproot it, O God, hallelujah. Block out your hand, O God. Uproot that family altar. 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 Against the lives of God. Majekulebalah. Madada kalabodan. Marekulabayan. And let it be replaced by a blessing of God. The Kwasi Kulabandihan. Zeze Bararosaya. Raga Bakantu Lebalai. Dizo Bayakala. Azekule Kalabandia, Adide Kalabandia, or put block cat and go put every plant of them in the lives of God. Now, body be up in the God. Thank you, hallelujah, Lord. Amen. By this service today, God's hand shall be heavy against the enemies in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. That gang up from your family lineage, that witchcraft from your family lineage, whatever is fighting from your foundation. They are feast the name of Jesus, hallelujah. By the hand of God that is out of his bosom now. Everything planted against your family right now, they are put in the name of Jesus, uprooted. The name of Jesus, uprooted. The name of Jesus, uprooted. Every plant of the devil against this church of God, they are put in the name of Jesus, hallelujah. See the hand of God. I receive upon my life to the hallelujah. And every yoke of poverty is destroyed. Every yoke of lack is destroyed. Every yoke of stagnation is destroyed. Every yoke of vulnerable is destroyed. Destroy the name of Jesus, hallelujah. So now pray that as I take my communion, I point myself, hallelujah. When the blood came, the hand of God came, Lord, by the blood, put your hand on me, hallelujah, and do miracles. Now pray, hallelujah, by the blood, put your hands on me, God. Let the blood command your hand on me, God, your hand for proofs, result, testimonies. Your hand that brings testimony, result, proofs. Let your hand come, you go, Master. Your hand for proofs, oh God. As I partake, let your good hand rest on me, and oh God, for results, for proofs, for results, for proofs. Your good hand, oh God, for proofs in my business, for proofs in ministry, for proofs in our jobs, for proofs in our children, for proofs, my Rakan. On your children, God, let your come upon our children, God, for proofs academically, God, for proofs, mental prowess, excellence of God, my yekula on our children, God, mental prowess, let your hand rest in the God, for mental prowess, power, power, my yekula, deliverance of God, by your hand to the God, my dek, my Lord, God, thank you for answering prayer, Lord, hallelujah, he's blessed as the body for us, hallelujah, you know, we'll take it as the body touch your tongue. You are cleansed, hallelujah. For the end of Isaiah 6:6-8, hallelujah. And as you take the communion, you are purged of your heart and conscience, hallelujah, to serve God. As you partake, God's hand shall come on you, hallelujah, and do miracles in your life, hallelujah. It is done. This cup by faith is done, hallelujah. This cup of blessing which you bless, so the content is blessing. So every curse in your life is gone in the name of Jesus, hallelujah. Every curse in your family is gone in the name of Jesus, hallelujah. Every curse on this church is called in the name of Jesus, hallelujah. You are blessed. You are blessed. By the bloodline, you are blessed. You are empowered for goodness. And mercy of God upon your life. Hallelujah. Shall I see the hand of God upon my life? Hallelujah. By this hallelujah, it is done for you. Hallelujah. Amen. You will testify because the arm of the wicked, the one is broken in your life. Hallelujah. Broken today in your life. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Chile, chile, oh yo yo, chile. Hallelujah. Chile, chile, oh yo yo, chile. He never remote mana run. Aha, you are excellent. Hallelujah, you are excellent. Hallelujah. Worship and thank you for him. Thank you for his good hand in your life. His hand has come down on this church in your life. And Moab is crushed. Hallelujah. Thank you for your power, oh God. Thank you for grace. Hallelujah. The Lord bless and keep us. The Lord bless and keep you. The Lord bless and keep you. The Lord bless and keep you. Give you peace. Give you peace. You are going from strength to strength. Power is yours. Favor is yours. Hallelujah. Your going and coming is blessed. Say, I'm blessed of God. I cannot be cursed. Hallelujah. Say, I prosper. You're like, do hallelujah. You are blessed. Hallelujah. Thank God for all he's done. Give him praise and thank him for what he has done for you today. Magnify his name and give praise. Thank him. Give God praise. Hallelujah. Give him the glory and praise.
Thank you, Lord.
Worship
Jesus.
Him.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank
Jesus.
You, Holy Ghost.
Thank you, Lord. Amen. Jesus. Amen. Praise the Lord. Just give God thanks and praise one more time for that awesome service. Glorify the name of the Lord. Praise him. Thank him because the hand of God has come afresh upon your life to do you good, to change situation for your life, to transform your life, and to grant you everlasting peace. Glorify his holy name. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Take all the glory and the praise for just now giving thanks. Amen. Please, and surely God's goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives, and we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. Peace. Praise the Lord. Please congratulate one or two persons. Congratulate them concerning the service for the hand of God that is manifested in our lives. Hallelujah.